tour of my studio, my home recording studio. I have on a small loft in our house, and it's a little studio, but it's well capable of doing good recordings because of some budget but very good equipment I've managed to find over the years. Every home studio starts with a computer and a DAW where you record your music on. I'm using Ardour, a Linux-based program for recording. As an input, my main input these days is my Behringer Euphoria UMC 404 HD. It's a very good interface. It has four channels in, four channels out, and all kinds of functions. I have a different video about this on my channel, so I'll link that in the description. There's lots of guitars here. As you can see, this is one I built myself. This is my Washburn acoustic, and it has a element in it I bought on a Chinese website. My BM800 microphone, condenser mic for recording vocals and guitars. My Fostex T15RP headphone. I'm using that for final mixes. My main tool for drum and bass these days is my Trio Band Creator from Digitech. I have a pedal that goes with it, foot switch. Well, happens to be two of my most favorite pedals are here. Yo-Yo American Sound. Akai MIDI keyboard, and as you can see, I'm not a good keyboard player. I have the notes written on it. Below that is my computer, a Celeron computer I built myself. It's a very small and silent computer. As you can see, it's running now, but you don't hear a thing because it's all fanless. Below that there's an amp. I use it to amplify these huge speakers. I only use them to listen back tracks I've recorded. Here's another mic. I use a McCript condenser. It's a pretty old mic, by the way, but still works very fine. In the back, some other mics for recording guitar, acoustic guitar. That's all I have and all I need for recording. There's of course more microphones and more stuff in boxes and wires and all other stuff, but this is the most important: the DAW, the interface, little keyboard guitars. And here's something before I forget. This is my little Behringer Eurorack UB802, and I've recorded many albums with it, but these days I don't use it that much anymore. Now, below the little Behringer mixer and the amp, there's a big black box, and in it there's a 16 channel mixer. I've used it to record some stuff, but well, for a home studio, a 16 channel mixer is of course overkill. I got it from my brother in Norway, and of course I'm keeping it because I got it for free, and it's a very nice present, and I want to use it in the future if I ever build a bigger studio or have a bigger space. And finally, there's something I'm really proud of. It's something that got most of us started years ago: a small four-track recorder for cassette recording. I've recorded a few songs with it recently, and I still like it a lot. I want to hook up it to my Behringer one day soon to do some semi-live recordings and make comparisons between the analog and digital sound. As you can see, I did only minimal sound treatment to the room. I think that's enough for me. It is. So that's the environment I work and record in.